Hey there, my name is Dimitri, and in this video, I'm gonna dive into why I use Morgen Calendar. It's a calendar app that's been out for a long time, but I don't think it's known by enough people. It's simply effective at doing what you need to get your day planned, and it is that single tool that has changed my daily planning workflow and allowed me to have a Google Calendar that, as you can see, is not only packed, but accurately organized, color-coded, and kept up with. Let's dive right into it. So as you can see on my Morgen Calendar, there's a lot of really cool things that I'm able to do here. First and foremost, I have imported calendars across multiple accounts. I have calendars on my personal account, on my business account, and on another small account that I have for consulting. Now, what I end up doing with all these different calendar accounts is I actually end up color coding them. And I think this is one of the primary ways that Morgen is so great. As you can see across many different calendars, I can color them to my specific preference utilizing whatever color I'd want. So as you can see in the dropdown here, I can pick a specific hex code and change it at any time. And not only that, but if there's a number of different calendars that I actually would prefer not to see, I can uncheck them from the list. Like when I had a Todoist sync, if I don't want to see the example calendar and otherwise. And this kind of leads me further into this idea of customizability is the fact that, as you can see here in my calendars, when I press this, there are these symbols that showcase like a number. Now, what I can do in order for my videos to make it really easy is I can press the number 3, and this is an example calendar that I can use, showcasing a calendar that wouldn't have my personal data and planning in this manner instead of going through and doing it in the other ways where if I press 1, I can see my actual calendar, and then on 2, I can see what I like to call my calendar framework, which ends up being what I wish my week would look like if I kept things in an organized manner. Now, all three of these are color-coded, and not only that, if I show you something pretty cool here, I actually have a pretty incredible system built out on this, which is called Travel. So as you can see, I'm trying to watch the marathon, or an ultra marathon on this date, and I want to drive to the event. So say I remember that it's kind of far out, so I gotta go make some adjustments to my calendar real quick, one moment. Say I know that I'm gonna drive here, I can say drive to ultra marathon. Now it's gonna be about for an hour, and I know that it's on my little life events calendar, which obviously has a different color. But there's sometimes where you want to categorize things even more so than the calendar you put them on. Because this calendar is cool because I can basically have it so that it's like blocking any meetings from happening during that time. But as you can see here, I could press traveling and then it grays it out. So yes, it's on my life events slash hold. And if I put a little emoji, it'll end up being on this date and have this little traveling indicator, which I can change the color of the tag in any way I want. If it was a break between different times at work, you know, if I wanted to categorize breakfast as a break, I could absolutely do that. It would gray it out. And graying it out isn't the only option. It's just the color I keep tending to show you for that. So if I like remove this tag and picked health, for example, it would make it green. Now that is really cool overall. And I appreciate the fact that this is a pretty quick and easy system to create with all the different customizable calendars. But what's also even better than that, in my opinion, which is number 2, is that you can take those different calendars and you can utilize something called booking pages and meeting links. So for example, I have a booking page here that I've copied out. And if I click on this discovery call, this is a link that I can send out individually as well, where someone can go here and they could book a time to talk to me. Now, booking a time to talk to me is only useful if it prevents people from booking a time when I'm available. They can only book a time when I'm available, right? So if I go to my discovery call settings here, you'll see there's this discovery call, 32 meetings booked. If I press edit link, you'll see that I'm available essentially from like 9 to 2 p.m. With a little break in the middle, and then 3:30 to 6:30 on Tuesday through Thursday. And then, as you'll see here, it can set the specific calendar that that event would go on. So it'd be called meetings. And then it cross-references who necessarily can actually book a call with me and how does it determine availability. As you can see here, there's check availability. If I click on 3 busy calendars, I can have it set to check my availability in my busy calendars. And across my entire account, you'll see that this calendar, life events, and meetings, all three of these are where meetings or life events are occurring where I don't want like a meeting to be booked. So it prevents anybody from booking a call with me, but they can simply click on this link and book a call with me if they want. Now, these two things are really important, right? The having multiple different calendars aggregated, having the links, that's amazing, right? So we have the ability for people to bring all their calendars together, have all their meetings booked through this and get your availability. There's a ability to create quick links too, where for example, I have like something on a random Tuesday where I'm like, oh, I'm okay, fine. We can do a call on a Friday. I just want it here. I can then click open invite and then send a one-time link by changing the length of it, adding conferencing and setting it to my meetings calendar. And then by quickly naming it to like quick sync with Jack, they can book a 30-minute slot from any time that I drag on here, right? Create and copy link, send it out, the same shtick. And last but not least, the final reason why I use Morgen is because of the tasks capabilities. As you can see inside of here, I have the ability to daily plan. All of these are connected to my Notion, and I essentially get an inbox over here where I can drag and drop onto my calendar, as you can see. And those are then assigned to any of the calendars I want. And then when I finish the task, if I check it off in here, it gets checked off in Notion. This works the exact same way with like Todoist and ClickUp, with the idiosyncrasies of filters adjusting to different properties that you have, different sorting that you would have by different properties. You can show or unshow scheduled tasks on the side here. And when you're done daily planning, you can simply press the space bar and you have your entire calendar back. I like keeping it open to the side so that I can actually end up planning my day here. But overall, this is a pretty simple process. You have all of your different calendars in one place. If you're busy between work, business, friend stuff, side hustle, working out, all of that can be color-coded, connected, and across multiple calendars in one single application. Now, how much does this cost? It's actually free if you end up keeping it to a limited amount of things like the built-in Morgen tasks and one calendar. However, if you want to get more than one calendar, you can get it for $9 a month. You get unlimited calendars, tasks integrations, time blocking, booking page and scheduling links. And all of this stuff for me has been a major improvement to my productivity. So if you like it, make sure to check out the affiliate link down below. I've been working with Morgen for a couple years now, only out of the fact that like it is my daily calendar app. So when you purchase it, you're gonna be purchasing what I use on a daily basis because I enjoy it. With that being said, thank you so much for watching this video. I appreciate each and every one of you. Stay productive and I'll see you in the next one.